Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Danish ebook before it's gone.
Hi, jeg hedder Louise. Hi everybody, I'm Louise. Welcome to DanishClass101.com's Dansk på 3 minutter, the fastest, easiest and most fun way to learn Danish. In the last lesson, you learned how to introduce yourself in Danish. In this lesson, you learn how to use good manners as you thank people. Er I klar? Are you ready? Lad os begynde. So let's start. There's several ways to thank someone, so let's start with the easiest. It is just one word. Tak. Tak. Tak means thank you. When you say thank you very much, you just need to add mange at the beginning. Mange tak. Mange tak. Mange means many, so mange tak is like saying many thanks. During the last lesson, we didn't really mention anything about formality in speech in Danish. However, there are some subtle differences in how we will be perceived by others. Tak is the more casual way to thank someone, while mange tak expresses more gratitude, so it's slightly more formal or polite. A longer and more formal phrase, which expresses a lot of gratitude, would be tusind tak skal du have. Here we've changed mange to tusind, which means thousand, and added skal du have, which literally means you shall have. Tusind tak skal du have. But how do you answer these expressions of gratitude? It's easy. There are basically two different ways to do it. The first is velbekomme. Velbekomme. Velbekomme literally means you are welcome. The other way to say you are welcome is the expression det var så lidt. Det var så lidt. Literally, this phrase means it was so little and is equivalent to don't mention it, but it's the most common and polite way to respond to someone thanking you. So when someone says tak to you, you can simply reply with velbekomme or det var så lidt. Now it's time for Louise's insights. If you're not sure about whether to use tak or mange tak, keeping it simple is always your safest bet. You don't have to worry about formal or informal situations. Tak can be used with just about anyone, anywhere, and at any time. Do you know what vi ses means? In our next lesson, you'll learn this and other greetings in Danish. Tak, og vi ses næste gang.
How are your Danish listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
En mand og en kvinde kigger på menuen i en restaurant. Hvad bestiller manden?
Hvad bestiller du?
Pizzaen ser god ud. Jeg tror, jeg tager den.
Jeg fik pizza i går, så...
Okay så. Hvad med burgeren?
Det lyder lækkert. Den tager jeg.
Hvad bestiller manden? En mand og en kvinde kigger på menuen i en restaurant. Hvad bestiller manden?
Hvad bestiller du?
Pizzaen ser god ud. Jeg tror, jeg tager den.
Jeg fik pizza i går, så...
Okay så. Hvad med burgeren?
Det lyder lækkert. Den tager jeg.
Hej, jeg hedder Louise. Hi everybody, I'm Louise. Welcome to DanishClass101.com's Dansk på 3 minutter, the fastest, easiest and most fun way to learn Danish. In the last lesson, you learn how to be grateful to people by saying tak. In this lesson, you learn some of the most common greetings used in Denmark. Er I klar? Are you ready? Så lad os begynde. So let's start. The most used informal greeting is hi. Hi. Hi means hi. You can use it when you meet people and it can be used with anyone. But it isn't the only way to greet someone. We also have good day. Good day. It is a more time-specific greeting and is equivalent to hello. Literally, good day means good day. As a rule of thumb, you can use good day only during the daytime, from morning until evening. During the evening, we say god aften. God aften. Aften is Danish for evening, so god aften means good evening. Finally, in the mornings, we say god morgen. God morgen, which means good morning. God dag, god aften, and god morgen are used when we meet someone, but when we leave, we don't say these again. When parting ways for a long time, we usually say ha' det godt. Ha' det godt. Ha' det godt means be well, but a better translation is all the best. Finally, in Danish, we have an expression meaning see you. Vi ses. Vi ses. Now you can greet people in many different ways in Danish. Let's review them all again. When meeting friends or someone we don't know, hi or good day. In the morning, god morgen. In the evening, god aften. When leaving for a long time, ha' det godt. When leaving and implying see you soon, vi ses. It's easy, isn't it? Now it's time for Louise's insights. In formal situations, Danish people commonly greet each other by shaking hands. On the other hand, if we meet someone we are very friendly with, no matter their gender, it's common to give hugs. Don't be afraid to try it out with your Danish friends. During the next lesson, we learn the meaning of the phrase, taler du engelsk? Do you already know it? I'll tell you all about it in the next Dansk på 3 minutter lesson. På gensyn!
How are your Danish listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
En kvinde skal til at have frokost på en restaurant. Hvad bestiller hun?
Vil du have kaffe eller dessert efter måltidet?
Hvilke desserter har I?
Vi har budding eller æbletærte.
Faktisk så vil jeg bare have kaffe, tak.
Vil du have sukker og mælk til?
Mælk, tak. Hvad bestiller hun? En kvinde skal til at have frokost på en restaurant. Hvad bestiller hun?
Vil du have kaffe eller dessert efter måltidet?
Hvilke desserter har I?
Vi har budding eller æbletærte.
Faktisk så vil jeg bare have kaffe, tak.
Vil du have sukker og mælk til?
Mælk, tak.
Hej, jeg hedder Louise. Hi everybody, I'm Louise. Welcome to DanishClass101.com's Dansk på 3 minutter. The fastest, easiest and most fun way to learn Danish. In the last lesson, you learned how to count in Danish. I hope you spent some time practicing the numbers, because they will come in handy for this lesson. You're going to learn how to go shopping in Denmark. Before we go, you need to know how to say how much is it? Hvor meget koster den? Hvor meget koster den? Okay, are you ready to go shopping in Denmark? Let's go. You see something you like and want to ask a shopkeeper how much it costs. The first thing to say is undskyld. Do you remember what that means? Excuse me. Undskyld, hvor meget koster den? Undskyld, hvor meget koster den? Now in Danish, the object that you point at is either den or det. There are no rules for when to use den or det, so you'll have to learn them by heart. But don't worry, Danes will understand you even if you use the wrong one, so just go ahead and try. Undskyld, hvor meget koster den? Undskyld, hvor meget koster det? There's one more pronoun you can use when pointing at a bundle of things you want. The pronoun de. Undskyld, hvor meget koster de? At this point, the shop clerk can answer by saying den koster, det koster, or de koster. For example, den koster 55 kroner, det koster 55 kroner, or de koster 55 kroner. What number is 55? Yeah, it's 55. So this means it cost 55 kroner. Now it's time for Louise's insights. The pronoun you will use most often is det, because not only is it used to ask prices of some objects, but also services, like if you want to get a haircut. So get used to asking with this. Hvor meget koster det? Hvor meget koster det? At this point, can you count kroner in Danish? We're going to learn how to do this and much more in the next lesson. I'll be waiting for you in a next Dansk på 3 minutter lesson. Vi ses næste gang. Hej, jeg hedder Louise.
Hi everybody, I'm Louise. Welcome to DanishClass101.com's Dansk på 3 minutter. The fastest, easiest and most fun way to learn Danish. In the last lesson, you learn how to use the verb at lave, which means to do in Danish. In this lesson, you will learn how to use at kunne lide, a very delightful Danish verb, which is also the third verb in our series dedicated to the most common Danish verbs. At kunne lide means to like in Danish. So in this lesson, you're going to see how to use it correctly. Let's go! Imagine you're in a restaurant with your fiancé and he or she asks you, kan du lide ost? This means, do you like cheese? So supposing you like it, even though it might sound like a weird question, you can answer, ja, jeg kan godt lide ost. Ja, jeg kan godt lide ost. So let's break down this answer. First we had ja, which is simply yes. Then jeg, which is I in Danish. After that we had kan lide, which is the present form of the verb at kunne lide. We also have godt, which translates as well, confirming that you do indeed like cheese. Finally, we had ost, which means cheese. Ja, jeg kan godt lide ost. You can use this verb with other verbs in infinitive form as well, to express that you like performing an action. Say you like climbing. In Danish, you would say it like, jeg kan godt lide at klatre. Jeg kan godt lide at klatre. Where a klatre means to climb. Make sure your verbs after lide are in the infinitive form with the at article in front of them. You can use this verb about a person as well. Like in English, you can say, I like you. In Danish, this would be, jeg kan godt lide dig. Jeg kan godt lide dig. Now, of course, this doesn't come close to the verb at elske, to love, but it does show a certain affection toward the other person. It can easily be used when you are at the stage where you don't quite want to say I love you just yet. If you want to say I love you, just change the verb at kunne lide to the verb at elske. At elske is the most romantic verb in Danish and is used more or less in the same way as love in English. Jeg elsker dig, meaning I love you, is probably one of the most romantic sentences you can say to someone. Jeg elsker dig. Now it's time for Louise's insights. At kunne lide is sort of bland if you want to express absolute love for an object or something. Like English, using I love chocolate is a much stronger way of expressing your feelings towards chocolate. In Danish, this would be jeg elsker chokolade. Jeg elsker chokolade. In this lesson, you learn how to use the verb at kunne lide and at elske. Next time we'll learn another very useful verb, at komme. I'll be waiting for you in the next Dansk på 3 minutter lesson. På gensyn! How are your Danish listening skills? First you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
En mand og en kvinde taler sammen. Hvad spiste kvinden til morgenmad? Jeg er sulten.
Spiste du morgenmad?
Ja, jeg gjorde, men jeg fik kun lidt.
Hvad fik du at spise?
Jeg fik yoghurt og kaffe.
Det er for lidt. Du burde have brød eller frugt til.
Hvad spiste kvinden til morgenmad? En mand og en kvinde taler sammen. Hvad spiste kvinden til morgenmad? Jeg er sulten.
Spiste du morgenmad?
Ja, jeg gjorde, men jeg fik kun lidt.
Hvad fik du at spise?
Jeg fik yoghurt og kaffe.
Det er for lidt. Du burde have brød eller frugt til.
Hi everyone, I'm Alicia. How are your Danish listening skills? In this video, you'll have a chance to test them out with a quiz. First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
En mand ringer til en restaurant over telefonen. Hvad tid lukker restauranten?
Undskyld mig, hvor sent har I åbent til?
Vi har åbent indtil klokken 23, Men sidste bestilling er klokken 22.
Åh, godt. Jeg troede allerede, I var lukket, fordi det er så sent.
Vi plejede at lukke klokken 22, men vi har udvidet åbningstiden.
Åh, okay.
Men vi lukker restauranten klokken 21 om søndagen.
Okay, forstået.
Hvad tid lukker restauranten? En mand ringer til en restaurant over telefonen. Hvad tid lukker restauranten?
Undskyld mig, hvor sent har I åbent til?
Vi har åbent indtil klokken 23, men sidste bestilling er klokken 22.
Åh, godt. Jeg troede allerede, I var lukket, fordi det er så sent.
Vi plejede at lukke klokken 22, men vi har udvidet åbningstiden.
Åh, okay.
Men vi lukker restauranten klokken 21 om søndagen.
Okay, forstået.
Great work. Here's a reward. Speed up your language learning with our PDF lessons. Get all of our best PDF cheat sheets and ebooks for free. Just click the link in the description. Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Danish ebook before it's gone.